We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Hello and welcome everyone. In this lecture, I'll be discussing about elastic pressure transducer. This type of transducer uses elastic primary sensing element like Bowden tube, diaphragm, bellows and capsules. This elastic transducer converts the pressure signal into proportional mechanical displacement. The first type is Bowden tube pressure gauge. The Bowden tube pressure gauge consists of an elastic element, a small volume tube of oval cross section bent in circular arc fixed at one end and free at other end. The fixed end is open for application of pressure which is to be measured, and the other end is closed but free to allow displacement under elastic deformation action of pressure difference across the tube wall. The free end is attached with sector through adjustable connecting link. The sector is in mesh with pinion and on which fixed pointer which can rotate on calibrated scale. This is the Bowden tube and this is stem. Pressure is applied from this direction. Now let us discuss its working. A Bowden tube works based on the principle as pressure increases inside the oval cross section. This is the oval cross section. It tries to change its cross section. When the pressure increases, it tries to change from oval to circular cross section, and this tends to straighten the tube. As the fluid under pressure here enters the Bowden tube, this causes tube to uncoil by dotted line over shown here. Uncoil the tube. Here cross section of tube is oval, so movement of tip of free end is parallel to minor axis, and adjustable link sector and pinion are connected to the tip point that converts the linear motion of tip into proportional. So here there will be the linear motion of this tip, and this angularity screw, multiplication screw and sector will convert the linear motion into rotary motion, proportional rotary motion, which given to pointer that moves on the calibrated scale in terms of pressure. A hair spring is connected to the spindle on which sector is mounted that provides necessary tension for meshing sector and pinion, thus eliminating any backlash. There are three types of cross section of Borden tube element. First one is, these are the various shape, which are C shape. Then another shape is spiral shape. Another third shape is helical shape. And various material used for Borden tube are of brass, then phosphorus bronze, then monel beryllium, copper and stainless steel. The pressure for phosphorus bronze varies from 100 to 700 kilonewton per meter square, and for alloy steel it is from 7000 to 630000 kilonewton per meter square. Here the tip travel The displacement of tip is given by delta A equal to 0.05 AP by E into R by T raised to 0.2 into X by Y raised to 0.33 into x by t into raised to 3, where delta A is the deflection of tip, then a is the total angle subtended by the tube before pressurization, which can be from 200 to 300 degree for oval cross section and circular cross section. P is the pressure applied and E is the modulus of elasticity of tube material, while R is the radius of tube up to central of oval section. T is the thickness of tube material, while x and y were the major and minor axis for the tube section. There are some advantages of Borden tube pressure gauge. It is simple in construction, low cost, high pressure range and good accuracy expect at low pressure. They are easily adopted for design to obtain electrical output. There are some disadvantages: low spring gradient, which limits their use for precision measurement up to 300 kilonewton per meter square, then susceptible to shock and vibration. Gauges are subject to hysteresis. So there are various errors associated with Borden gauges, and what are their causes and what are their rectification. Let us discuss them one by one. First error is zero error. Now this is the constant error. this remain constant over the entire pressure range. The cause can be pointer become loose on spindle. So remedy is keeps the pointer in correct position. Second one is multiplication error. This is the second multiplication error. This is because of due to stress developed in bourdon tube, the actual travel of tip is non-linear. However, small tip travel of tip is considered to be linear and parallel to, known as multiplication, and can be adjusted by adjusting the length of lever. A shorter lever gives larger rotation for same amount of tip travel. Any wrong setting in multiplication mechanism between bourdon tube and pointer spindle may tend to give progressively high or low reading. This error is known as multiplication error. The cause is wrong setting in multiplying mechanism between bourdon tube and pointer spindle. Remedy is multiplication screw is loosened and the connecting mechanical link is moved either a little inward when the gauge reading low and little outward when the gauge reading high. So from this we can say by changing this multiplication screw we can eliminate the multiplication error. And third error is of angularity error. This is the third one because of this. When approximate linear motion of tip is converted to circular motion with link lever and pointer attached, a one-to-one correspond between them may not occur. This is known as angularity error. In this, in which the gauge may read correctly both at maximum and minimum reading but gives inaccurate reading in midpoint. This cause can be the distorted tube. This error can be minimized by adjusting the length of connecting lever by angularity gauge. Next type of elastic pressure transducer is diaphragm pressure gauge. Here a thin diaphragm, the thin plate of circular shape clamped firmly around its edges. When the pressure is applied either side of the tight diaphragm, it gets deflected. This deflection of the diaphragm is proportional to the differential pressure across it. A diaphragm pressure gauge consists of a thin flexible diaphragm, thin circular disc clamped firmly around its edges inside an enclosure. One side of diaphragm is exposed to pressure to be measured and other end is exposed to atmosphere or reference pressure as shown in figure. The deflection of diaphragm is transmitted to gauge dial by linkage connected to center of diaphragm. If the pressure is applied to the lower side of diaphragm is greater than the atmospheric pressure on the upper side, the diaphragm is deflected to upward direction. Hence, the pointer indicates pressure on the calibrated scale. This will indicate like this. If the pressure are equal on both side, then the if it is equal on both side, then it will show no movement. So here the pressure at absolute pressure will be equal to atmospheric plus gauge pressure. For equal pressure, the gauge pressure will be zero, so absolute pressure will be equal to the atmospheric pressure when pressure in liquid is equal on both side of diaphragm, indicating can be set to non value. Let us discuss the various shape and material of diaphragm. Here are the various types of diaphragm. It can be of flat, corrugated or capsule type. The flat type is often used in conjunction with the electrical secondary transducer, in which very small deflection can be detected. And the corrugated and capsule type are used where large deflection. These are used for large deflection, while these are used for small deflection. The diaphragm can be classified according to their material as metallic or non-metallic or slack diaphragm. The metallic diaphragm are made from the brass, phosphorus bronze, beryllium copper and stainless steel material, while the non-metallic are made from synthetic rubber, leather, teflon, neoprene and elastomers reinforced by cotton, nylon or dicron. The non-metallic diaphragm are used for low pressure and vacuum gauges. There are some advantages of diaphragm pressure gauge. It is small in size, moderate cost. It can measure absolute gauge vacuum and differential pressure. The correction resistant material, corrosion resistant material can be used, and adaptability to slurry service. It is having good linearity, can withstand high over pressure. The disadvantage are lack of variation and shock resistance. It is limited to relative low pressure and repairs works is difficult. The pressure deflection relation for flat diaphragm, the pressure and deflection relation is given by 16 E T raised to 4 divided by 3 R raised to 4 1 minus mu square into y by t. Here the p is the pressure difference across the diaphragm, y is the deflection of diaphragm at center, e is the modulus of elasticity, T is the thickness of diaphragm, R is the radius of diaphragm, and mu is Poisson's ratio. Now the last type of elastic pressure transducer is bellows pressure gauge. Bellows pressure gauge. In this, bellows is the elastic element, longitudinally expandable and collapsible member. It consists of several convolutions or folds which are fabricated and forming a drawn tube. The metallic bellows is most accurate when measuring pressure is between 3 kilonewton per meter square and 100 kilonewton per meter square. However, when used in conjunction with heavy range spring, some bellow gauges can be used to measure pressure range greater than 700 kilonewton per meter square. The bellows are made of an alloy which has high fatigue strength, ease of fabrication, and retain its properties over long use. Has very little hysteresis effect. Bellows are made of brass, phosphorus bronze, beryllium, copper, monel, and stainless steel. The choice of material depends upon the pressure range and corresponding resistance. A bellows gauge for measurement of gauge pressure or vacuum is shown in figure. When applied, pressure is fed into bellows. It acts on outside of bellows and gets compressed. Hence, free end of bellows move against the opposing force of spring. This free end moves is transmitted to pointer, and this partial rotation of pointer on calibrated scale represents the pressure fed outside bellows. The sensitivity of bellows gauge or deflection of bellows can be increased by increasing the bellows diameter and increasing the stroke length, which means the increasing the number of folds. Now here there is a differential bellows pressure gauge. In here, a bellows gauge used to measure differential pressure in which two bellows are connected to end of an equal arm lever, and if pressure applied, these are the two bellows, and here when the pressure is applied, both bellows are equal, they are deflected by same amount. They will deflect by same amount. The lever would rotate, but no movement would result in movement of sector, and hence no indication of pressure. Suppose this will move equally in upward direction and this will equally move in downward direction. So this point remain in same position, so no pointer will be indicated. But when the two applied pressure are different, then the pointer indicates the differential pressure of two applied pressure. If the one of the bellows is completely evacuated and acts in opposite to other bellow, the pointer deflection represents absolute pressure. So there are various advantages of bellows gauge, as it is simple in construction, measures gauge, vacuum, absolute and differential pressure, good in low to moderate pressure range and moderate cost. Whereas there are some disadvantages, that not suited for high pressure, it requires compensation for ambient temperature changes, it is not suitable for dynamic measurement due to mass and longer relative motion, it is used only in conjunction with reliable spring of applicable high stiffness for accurate characteristics. So this is the end of the topic. Thank you very much for watching this.